Hello students, now today we are going to start board sample paper which is issued by CBSE for class 10. See, what is the question number 1? Find A, for which points PA32 is the midpoint of line segment joining the points Q and R. So I am not writing the question, I am doing it directly. If you want questions, you can see my videos or you can go to CBSE website. So what is the question? Q and R. Q is given to you minus 5, 4. And R coordinates are given to you minus 1, 0. And here P is the midpoint which is given A by 3, 2. Now see, it is given that P is the midpoint. So the ratio will be 1:1. And we know the formula that x equal to x1 plus x2 upon 2 and y equal to y1 plus y2 upon 2. Now I am writing x value a upon 3 equal to x1 is minus 5 plus minus 1 upon 2. And here it becomes a upon 3 minus 6 upon 2. Cancel out minus 3. What is left? A equal to minus 9. See students, here you have to be careful that if a upon 3 is given at y place, then use this formula. But here, see, a upon 3 is given at x place. That is why I used this one. So don't waste the time. Use your time judiciously. Now I move to question number 2. Clear? Okay. Let us see question number 2. Find k, for which one root of the quadratic equation, see it is given kx square minus 14x plus 8 equal to 0. And here one root is given to you 2. So what you have to find out? Find k. This is your question. Find k. Now see, as one root is given to you 2, so as given one root is 2. One root is 2, therefore x equal to 2. Put the value of x in given equation, k 2 whole square minus 14, 2 plus 8 equal to 0, and it becomes 4k minus 28 plus 8 equal to 0, and see 4k equal to 20, or you can say k equal to 20 upon 4, that is 5, and this is your final answer. So what is the value of k here? 5. Now move to question number 3. Find k for which the x square plus 5kx plus 16 equal to 0 has real and equal root. See, what is the equation? X square plus 5kx plus 16 equal to 0. Here condition is given to you real and equal roots. What is the condition? Real and equal roots. So all of you know, when the roots are given real and equal, what happens? Discriminant become 0. Now what is discriminant? Discriminant is b square minus 4ac equal to 0. All of you know this. Now put the value of b, a and c. What is b? B is the coefficient of x. So write here 5k whole square minus 4 into 1, c is the constant, equal to 0, and here it becomes 25k square minus 64, and I am taking 64 to the right side, equal to 64, and k square equal to 64 upon 25, and what do we obtain? K equal to plus minus 8 upon 5. So this is the value of k. Clear? Now student, we move to the next question, and you have to remember here and you have to read the question carefully that which condition is given in the question. Now see, next question is from trigonometry section, that is cot square theta minus 1 upon sine square theta. See, now what will you do? What is cot? All of you know that cot is the inverse of tan theta. So tan theta is sine theta upon cos theta. So here we will write cos square theta upon sine square theta minus 1 upon sine square theta. Take this common, sine square theta, or you can say LCM. So cos square theta minus 1. Now what is cos square theta minus 1? See, we will do it on left, on right side of the copies. So sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1. This all of you know. And we have to obtain the value of cos square theta minus 1. So take 1 to this side, you will get cos square theta minus 1, shift sine square theta to that side, minus sine square theta. So right here, minus sine square theta upon sine square theta, and when you divide it, you get minus 1. So this is your answer of this question. See student, you have to be careful. जो भी आइडेंटिटीज हम यूज करते हैं या कोई हम थ्योरम यूज करते हैं वो हमेशा राइट साइड पे ब्रैकेट में कॉपीज में लिखा जाता है. उसको कभी भी यहाँ बीच में मत लिखो, हमेशा साइड में लिखो. और जब भी स्टेप शुरू करते हो तो या तो इक्वल टू से शुरू करो, और इफ इक्वल टू इज ऑलरेडी गिवन इन द इक्वेशन सो स्टार्ट विद इट रिप्लाइज. ये हमेशा ध्यान रखना, योर वर्क शुड बी नीट एंड क्लीन. Now move to next question. What is the next question? If sine theta equal to cos theta. See, good question it is. Sine theta equal to cos theta. Then find 2 tan theta plus cos square theta. What we have to find out? Then find 2 tan theta plus cos square theta. This is our question. So what will you do? See, I am taking its solution. Divide both sides by cos theta. Sin theta upon cos theta, and here cos theta upon cos theta. Write this word. Divide both sides by cos theta. Write it in bracket on right side. Now what do we obtain here? Tan theta. Because we know sin theta upon cos theta equal to tan theta, and here 1. Now remember the trigonometric ratios, that 1 is the value of tan 45 degree. It means theta equal to 45 degree. Now put this value of theta in asked question. 2 tan theta means tan 45 degree plus cos square 45 degree. 2 tan 45, what is the value of tan 45? 1, and cos 45 is 1 upon root 2, and when we do the square of root 2, what we obtain here? 1 upon 2. Take LCM and solve it, and we get the answer 5 upon 2. Clear? So this is the solution. First you have to find out here theta and put the value in of theta in given question. Now we move to next. Hello student, next question is what? See, if nth term of an AP is, what is given here? Nth term of an AP is given to you 2n plus 1. So what is the sum of its first three terms? See, what is the question? Sum of first three terms. Sum of first three terms is asked in the question. So what will you do? Write the solution. See, I am taking a equal to 1 to find out the first term. I will put here 1. So a1 equal to 2. 1 plus 1 equal to 3. Now, 3 terms are given. So, first term is a1 and last term will be A3. Write here 3. No, D also we want. No, no need of D. A3 plus 1. So 2, 3 just 6 and 1, 7. So in this way you can find two terms, first term and last term. Now we have asked sum of three terms. So write here sum of three terms. What is the formula? N upon 2, first term plus last term. There are total three terms. A is given to you 3 and L is given to you 7. So it becomes 3 upon 2 into 10 and it is 15. So what is the sum of three terms? It is 15. Clear? See, it's very easy question. But if you don't use here n equal to 1 to 3, you can't find out its answer. Because this is an indirect question. Now move to next question.
What is the next question?
See, this question is from similar triangle. One triangle is given to you here. A, B, C, and one line is drawn. We don't know whether this line is parallel or not because it is not given in the question. What is given? AB equal to 6 cm, BB equal to 9 cm, A equal to 8 cm, and EC equal to 12 cm. So, here students, first we will check whether the sides are in equal proportion or not. Here this angle is given to you 48 degree and this angle we have to find out. So what will you do? See, here you can write AD upon BD equal to AE upon CE. You can use also this side upon full side of this triangle. And this AE upon AC also you can use. I am taking half of side. You can take half upon full also. So we should check the ratio first. See, here it is 6 upon 9 and it is 8 upon 12. 4 2 ja, 4 3 ja, 3 2 ja, 3 3 ja. We obtain the equal ratio. It means that we can follow the basic proportionality theorem that if the sides are in proportion, then the lines are parallel. So, what will you say? This suggests that line BE parallel to, therefore BE parallel to BC by using BPT theorem. BPT theorem is basic proportionality theorem. Now see, when the lines are parallel, we know corresponding angles are equal. Therefore, angle ABE equal to, ADE equal to angle ABC equal to 48 degree. In bracket, you have to write the reason corresponding angles. Clear? So, in this way, you can find out this angle. This is also 48 degrees. Now come on, move to next question. See, what is the question? After how many decimal places will the decimal expansion of 23 upon 2, 4 into 53 terminate? See, in this question, student, it is asked that decimal place will come after which place. इस क्वेश्चन को मैं थोड़ा सा और चेंज कर रही हूँ. इसको हम एक और चीज इसमें निकाल लेते हैं कि उसका डेसिमल क्या होगा. ये क्वेश्चन के एग्जाम में आ सकता है. So how will you do it? 23 upon, write it 2 upon 3 into 5 upon 3. 1, 2 is left here. So 2 upon 1 and to make the pair of 2, we add 5 upon 1 in denominator and also in numerator. जो हम denominator में add करते हैं, वो हमेशा numerator में भी add हमको करना पड़ता है. अब देखो, इसको मैं ऐसे लिख सकती हूँ, 23 into 5 upon you can write 2 to the power of 4 and 5 to the power of 4. So we can write it directly 2 into 5 to the power 4. इसीलिए मैंने इसको एक बार अलग कर दिया था कि हम कितने 5 चाहिए टू बी द पेयर टू कन्वर्ट इट इनटू द बेस 10. अब देखो ऊपर क्या आया मेरे पास है न्यूमरेटर में 5 से 15 5 कैरी 1 11 एंड इट इज 10 टू द पावर ऑफ 4. नाउ यू कैन इजीली कन्वर्ट इट इनटू डेसिमल. हाउ? 4 प्लेसेस आर देयर इन दिस वे यू कैन फाइंड आउट इट्स डेसिमल. देखो अभी जो हमने सैंपल पेपर में क्वेश्चन पूछा है उसमें केवल हमें प्लेसेस बतानी है. सो यू हैव टू राइट हियर ओनली 4 प्लेसेस ऑफ डेसिमल. लेकिन अगर तुमसे पूछा जाता है व्हाट विल बी द डेसिमल तो तुमको ये पूरा मेथड करना है. क्लियर? सो आई थिंक यू कैन डू ऑन दिस क्वेश्चन. दिस वॉज द सेक्शन ए जिसमें कि 1 मार्क क्वेश्चन थे और इसको हमको जितना फास्ट कर सकते हैं हमको करना है. और कभी भी सेक्शन ए को सबसे पहले ऐसा नहीं करो कि सेक्शन सी पहले ले रहे हैं सेक्शन बी ले रहे हैं. हमको हमेशा लाइनवाइज चलना है सेक्शन ए सेक्शन बी सेक्शन सी. जैसे जैसे तुम आगे बढ़ते जाओगे तुम्हारी स्पीड भी बढ़ती जाएगी क्योंकि सेक्शन ए में छोटे छोटे क्वेश्चन दिए होते हैं उससे हमारी स्पीड भी बढ़ती है हमारा कॉन्फिडेंस भी बढ़ता है. और बिकॉज दीज आर ओनली 1 मार्क क्वेश्चन. नाउ इन नेक्स्ट वीडियो आई विल टीच यू सेक्शन बी. ओके स्टूडेंट्स थैंक यू.